Good afternoon, class. Before we start, we ask guidance to our Creator, God Almighty. Let's say a prayer first for protection. The light of God surrounds me. The love of God involves me. The power of God protects me. The presence of God watches over me. The mind of God guides me. The life of God flows through me. The laws of God direct me. The power of God abides within me. The joy of God uplifts me. The strength of God renews me. The beauty of God inspires me. And wherever I am, God is. Thank you. Para ma-enlighten tatanan sa panahon karon na COVID, may pray for protection. Once again, I'm your instructor, Mark Anthony Lojan, registered criminologist. Our course for today is crime detection and management. Topic, special crime investigation. Date, October 8, 2020. Class, online class. Methodology, video lecture. Lesson objectives. After this lesson, the students will be able to define what is a special investigation, discuss what is homicide investigation, define homicide crime scene, describe the primary jobs of the investigator, enumerate the responsibility of a homicide investigator, state the mistakes in the homicide investigation, and last, cardinal rule of homicide crime scene. Introduction. Special crime investigation deals with the study of major crime based on the application of special investigation techniques. So, when you say special investigation techniques, these are applied sciences. Like, for example, legal medicine. So, mga applied sciences na siya to determine how the crime happened and why the crime happened and where did the crime happen. So, that is very important for an investigator to have the special techniques used to in identifying the crime scene. So again, the study of this, the special crime investigation, concentrates more on physical evidence. So special crime investigation nag-focus lang siya sa physical evidence, its collection, handling, identification, and preservation in coordination with the crime laboratory. So once again, naja po yung mga legal medicine ani na involved. The special crime investigation involves a close relationship between the prober in the field and the crime laboratory technician. So, kinsa to nagbuhat sa krimen o katong nagpreserve sa ebidensya, na sila relationship duha. They work together as a team, reacting to and extending to one another's theories and finding both working patiently and thoroughly to solve the crime from their investigative discoveries. So, very important talaga ang mga techniques sa crime scene kay dili basta-basta ang mag preserve, collect o identify sa kriminal na nagbuhat sa krimen. The present criminal justice system in our country, the court relies more on physical evidence rather than extrajudicial confession. So diri sa Pilipinas, ang atong mga korte gabay sila sa conviction sa tao or sa probable cause based on evidence, dili kaysa statement lang sa isa ka tao. Okay. Homicide investigation. So, homicide investigation, what is homicide investigation? It is the official inquiry made by the police on the facts and circumstances surrounding the death of the person which is expected to be unlawful. So, inquiry na naman, nagimo na pud ang investigator og mga inquiry sa witness, either sa victim, kumboy pang victim. So homicide ani, either wala na ang victim or sa mga witness na siya nag-inquire. Kung unsa ba naitabo sa krimen, kung nabay foul play or what you call this, kanang intentional ba gipatay ang tao. The facts circulating within the crime. So kailangan importante talaga na inquire og ayo ang mga ebidensya kung tinuod ba ni or dili. So is a highly professional and specialized undertaking. So mayon ka specialized undertaking ang undergo ani mga specialized rayon na tao para makita nyo sa flash news kanang na crime scene na mga what you call this na incident involving robbery, so na ay patay. So ang suko ang ga enter sa area within the area and sila ang mag-preserve and collect kung unsa ang mga dapat i-collect para ma-identify na unsa ang panghitabo within the area no cause sa death o unsa gamit sa pagpatay, mga importante. So undertaking specialized and professional, so ang maka undergo ra ni katong na ay well trained, na ay kuan siya na professional siya na naka-undergo sa mga trainings about collection and preservation of evidence which requires years of practical experience. So kailangan sa kamulo ni mong dili man ni mo ni siya madiritso makuha diritso ang ma-perfect ni mo ang pag-collect o pag-preserve. So kailangan ni mo pila ka tuig na mga years na experience. So ang ibig sabihin na when you do it every day, you will perfect it. I will perfect it ba kung every day ni mo gina-preserve, gina-collect ang mga ebidensya. So kadugayan ma-perfect ra din ni mo ang what is you call this practical experience coupled with the process of continual education and training. So continuing education and training, so bisan kung naka ka ng professional na ka and na naka specialized training, kailangan japon ni mo na mag train pa ka, mag educate pa ni mo ang tao unsaon ni mo ma-preserve or ma-collect, dili matampered ang ebidensya na ma-prove yun ni mo na insakto ang ebidensya o makuha ni mo unsang naitabo within sa crime scene. Primary job of the investigator. So primary job, yung kag-primary, mga first job, first priority jobs na buhaton niya. So yung first task, so to discover whether an offense has been committed under the law. So naabay krimen na itabo. To discover how it was committed. So pag-discover sa how it committed, kailangan na nag-special trainings. Who committed it and be whom it was committed. So kinsa ang nag-commit o kinsa ang buhatan sa crime. So example, ako ang nag-commit o kinsa akong gipatay, bali ana mo siya, identify ni mo ni siya dapat when it was committed, when. So kanus-a importante ya po na. And under certain circumstances why it was committed. So ma-distinguish na to ang murder or homicide dari na part, kay kung murder na yun na intention, pag homicide without intention, without malice. Okay, pero special crime man eh, so without malice na dya po yung krimen, without intention muna yung timanan about special crime. Without intention krimen Japan. So example, picture homicide crime scene. So example, mo sa example class na bali gidungga man babae, basin gi tangka ni siya o grab tapos wala niya gihatag ang iyang kwarta, itong kapsa din walay na, nakuha sa iya, walay na, walay ang iyang pitaka, wala ay wala na, wala yung kwarta, yung cellphone na rajapon, wala na tanduk ang iyang pagkatao, wala siya ginsa. Bali ang nagpatay ni morg na hadlupod ngano gitunggap niya ni. So nitawag ni siya na homicide crime scene picture. Explain na nako na ang pag further sa collection of evidence pun sa atong mga muabot na mga lecture class. Responsibilities of a homicide investigator. So nakay primary job, so unsa naman imong responsibilidad karon? So bali investigator ka. So when called upon to investigate violent death, he stands on the dead man's shoes to produce his instincts against those suspects. So pag ikaw ang nag-imbestigar, ang kontani mo ang mga suspect. So o ikaw po bali ang biktima, ikaw po itong imong i-prove na sila yun ang suspect. The enthusiasm and intelligence the investigator brings in the case marks the difference between a murderer being convicted and set free. So may yung enthusiasm kanang strong excitement or feeling something inspiring sa investigator, na inspired investigator. Intelligence is the ability to understand and learn. Muna siya intelligence sa investigator. Okay. If he interprets a criminal death, accident, or natural, a guilty person is set free. So, pag sayop ang interpretation sa criminal death, na ang criminal death may imong natural death, the guilty person is set free. So, simple lang kayo na class. Remember that the police is the first line of defense in the effective application of criminal justice. So, when you say CGS, ang police yun ang first line of defense, one of the five pillars of criminal justice system. Mistakes in the homicide investigation. Kung mayong mistakes in the homicide investigation, ano siya? The mistakes of a homicide investigator cannot be corrected. So, kung masayop ang investigator pag-collect, then pag-present sa court, magagawas yun ang criminal. Eh, dili naman pwede niya ibalik to. Kay mabalik pa siya kay mag-imbestigar ruto lang, dili na pwede. So importante yun ang collection and preservation sa pag-understand sa crime scene. The homicide investigator should not cross the three bridges when he burns behind him. So three bridges, unsa man eh, the dead person has been moved, the cadaver is embalmed, the body is burned or cremated. So pag ang namatay na tao, gimove gani siya, dili na nimo ma-predict kung asa siya dapat gipatay o yun sa siya pagpatay. Kay siyempre from one place to another naman siya. So kadaver po gi-involve po, nag-undergan na siya mga chemicals sa iyong lawas. So pag autopsy na, maglisod na nimo siya makuha ang oras kung kanus sa siya namatay o kanus apod siya, unsa po ang reason nga namatay siya. Kay na naman siya mga chemicals. So the body is born or cremated. Kung ang body or born cremated, remember class, dapat fire destroy every evidence, but fire also ang fire food napoy ebidensya sa fire. Dito na sa arson investigation, basta yung kag destroy evidence, fire yun na. So burn, body cremated, wala na ebidensya. Inga sunog na, abo na tanan, sud na kaya na imong i-explain na kung yun sa siya pagpatay or ang one thing na namatay yun siya, nasunog yun siya. Pero dili ni mo siya ma-determine kung namatay ba siya daan before siya na-cremated. Okay, class. And first, ayaw yung kalimti kung namo yung mga questions regarding sa lecture, pwede rin niyo i-PM sa messenger. Salamat. Cardinal rule of homicide crime scene. Ang say cardinal rule, so to protect and preserve the crime scene. So protect, na proteksyonan, preserve, dili nimo sa pwede madaot ba? Dili pwede madaot ang ebidensya. kung unsang gikuha na bilin sa at the first day, mura japon ang dagway sa bilin sa at the second day or third day. However, before a crime scene can be protected, it must be identified as such. So, lisod po kayo na mag-collect na ka na dili. Ito siya part of evidence. So, kailangan mo identify na kana siya, ebidensya. Class. So, in order an officer to make an intelligent evaluation, learning ability to evaluate the crime scene, he or she must have an idea of what constitutes physical evidence. So, unsa ang mga unsay nag-characteristic o unsay what forms of physical evidence. First is dapat makita yun siya. Body of the crime is considered physical evidence. Weapon is considered physical evidence. So, unsay mo makita, umawiran, physical evidence na siya. And where the boundaries of the scene should be established in order to protect the evidence. So, asa na taman ka mag-investigar. Dili nang pwede na darira ka sa example, darira ka sa park, niabot na ka sa mall. Lisod naman kaya, dako na kayo. Kung dito ra ka nag-preserve sa park, dito ra dapat ka i-cordon ni mo area. So, dili ni mo sila pasudlan dito until such na ang inyong investigation or ang inyong mga conduct of correction or identifying preservation tanan, nauman na. Na-clear na po. Remember, muna konsulte, pag once an item of an evidence is removed or altered, it is impossible to restore it to its original position or condition. So, once gani na move ni mo ang dead body, so mag-form naman na siya og what you call this kanang post-mortem. Dito na siya i-discuss sa legal medicine class further in our lecture. Post-mortem, ang iyang blood nag-down na siya. So, pag i-move ni mo siya, ang blood na po, stickier, mutikman na ang blood, mugahe ba? So, dili na na mo siya ma-preserve. So, remember, once an item is evidence has been moved or altered, it is impossible to restore. So, importante yun sa isa ka investigador, mangutana yun sa witness kung kanina patay na lawas, isibog ba ni or ialsa ba ni or wala ba ni gitandog para manot niya daan unsa ang dapat niya buhaton. So, before we end the class, mag-leave ko as a note, a quote by one of my favorite philosopher or basin ka mo, favorito Japanese siya. Knowing other is intelligence. So, knowing yourself is true wisdom. Mastering other is strength. Mastering yourself is true power. So, inyo na sabton. Inyo na basahon og sabton. Sayang pasabot ani para makabalo mo. And that's all. Thank you.